my beefy butternut squash chili. Yes, you can help. So first things first, we've got a butternut squash that's already been peeled. Marcel, if you can just dice that for me, and it's gonna go into the chili later. So you know, what I did is I started off with some chuck, and I just cut it into chunks. That's why I call it beefy, because it's two layers of beef going down here, right? Okay. We're gonna get chunky, and then I'm gonna have some ground beef as well.
Double beef.
Double beef, baby.
Boom.
So what I did was I browned that into the pan. I'm not trying to cook it, just brown it with a little bit of fat. And then in that same Dutch oven, I've got some onion, garlic, red bell pepper going right now. That's what smells
so crazy good.
And then gonna start with some flavor from tomato paste.
Greatest.
Just a little squeeze. And the key here is it comes out so bright red, but the idea is to cook it down until it's a really deep brown. So in there, I'm gonna put some hot sauce. Your favorite hot sauce, right? Now, I'm gonna add in my seasoning. The same seasoning that I'm gonna add in now is just half of what I already put onto my ground chuck. And that's gonna be some black pepper, oregano, salt, chili powder, pumpkin pie spice.
What?
It's awesome because it's got the cinnamon, the ginger, it's really warm, and some cumin. All right, so right in here, that seasoning blend, the other half of it that didn't go into the ground chuck.
The hot sauce just made it down here.
Yeah.
It's tickling my nose.
Now, into the pan right now, I've got the ground chuck. That's just 80%, 20%. You know, if you get the sirloin, it's just not going to have enough fat to hang out.
Most people would think chili has beans, Sunny. So what's your...
I'm a no-bean girl in my chili. I'm
no-bean girl
in my chili. But I've been around so many different places, Detroit chili, Texas chili. I mean, I'll just take it how it comes, but I prefer no beans.
Me too. I'm with ya.
I think that people put the beans in because they're like, hey, let's put a little bit more texture, and we're gonna get that with the butternut squash. So now that I've got the beef mostly brown, I can add back in the chuck that I chucked up before. I love cinnamon and chili, a nice little hint of it, and pumpkin pie spice has it, and right at the end, I'm gonna do a second layer of that chili for you. So just get the beef in there and incorporate it. And the beefy butternut squash. This really happened because I had a butternut squash sitting around. I was gonna make chili, and I was like, why not? It's gonna soak up the flavor. It's bright. It's gonna bring some color to it. And it works out. You can also do this with sweet potatoes. Cornmeal.
Thicken it up.
I love cornmeal and chili. It just kind of thickens it up, makes a little bit of a gravy for you at the end, tightens it for you. So over the top of that, some beef stock.
This is like the perfect Halloween meal.
A little red wine in there. And then just cover it up, cook it down. You know, it takes about 40, 45 minutes or so for everything to get nice and tender. And then you have...
Bubbling garlic.
A little beefy butternut squash.
Wait, I'm adding a garnish.
So here's the idea. You take a tortilla, of course I'm gonna add a tortilla. You could just take a cookie cutter and cut out a shape. And then just like you would fry a tortilla chip with 350-degree oil until it's nice and golden brown, you fry them, and you get the shapes like this. See that? Really important, though, you have to salt it when they're nice and warm so that the tortilla actually absorbs the salt. Otherwise, it'll just fall off. So add that nice, crunchy. You can do one of each.
Oh, there you go. So good.